Hello everyone, welcome to .NET Techie. So it's time to learn CRUD operation with material design in Angular 6. And why you should learn this? Because the reason behind this is that there is a lot of difference if you are working for Angular 4 and Angular 5 and you would like to call web API or restful services. What all the differences is there, I will let you know. So let me tell you first thing. So what you are gonna to learn by end of this tutorial. So here is this main screen, which is having these many controls. So in order to make it meaningful, what I have done is I have included almost all controls. So let's say I have included drop down list. I have included text box. I have included radio button. I have included validations in the control, and if I'm not entering these things, it will show on the red color. So this is what you will learn by end of this tutorial, and how I have achieved it, I will show you the code line by line. And if still you require, and even end of the tutorial, if you are worried about the module.ts, I will show the module.ts as well, what all the component and module has been loaded over there. Let's say address is Bangalore. I'm trying to fill it up, and I will say save over here. So did you notice it? If address is not filled up, this save button is disabled, and if I have filled this address, then save button is enabled. Let me hit the save button. Okay, customer inserted successfully. So what customer we have inserted? We have inserted this customer. Let us go and verify whether really customer has been inserted or not. This is my web API which is running on this port, and it says that the recently inserted record is this one, the last one, deep.gmail.com. This is what I have inserted it. So now let us go to the code and have a walkthrough on the code. So I will tell you first things. So everything almost, if you are not aware about how this navigation menu and how to get started with Angular 6 in material design, I would ask you to just go to youtube.com and browse .NET Techie YouTube channel and watch Get Started With You. Oh, over there, Angular 6 with material design. Okay, so I'm just browsing it up. This is what my video is. You could have walked through on other videos as well, which will show how to use Angular 6 with material design. For further videos and updates, you could go to my playlist and watch through what is there in Angular 6, what's new in Angular 6 and all those stuff. So that was my concern. If you are not aware about it, you can go and have a look on that thing. So first of all, this is my navigation bar which I am showing. It has been used as a selector. This is what customer details I am filling. Then I have created form group, customer form group over here. Then in that mat form field I am using, and I have applied some class called full width, and then mat for, if you want to have the drop down list, this is the code to create the drop down list and assign the value over there. So that's the first control. Second control is over here. This is my second control name. Third control is my radio button. I have put into the radio button, radio group, which you can use. Okay, similarly, next email, phone number. Then I have used date picker from the mat over here. And then Aadhaar number and then address. And here is my save button, which shows how this save should work. So if customer.form is not valid, then it will not enable the save button, because I have put the condition over there. Rest of the things is my message when insertion failed or succeeded. So this was the part of my HTML which I explained you. So how I have created the form over here. Let's jump to the app component.ts where all the operations I am doing it. Okay, so let's go to the top. Okay, yeah, all right, we are here. So these are the few things which you need to import. This is service which is helping me to post the data to API. This is my model which I would like to post it, and these are the things which you should commonly use if you are working with the forms and Angular core. Okay, so I have used customer service as a provider over here, which is very much title I have just given null, is failed message and is success message. I have given a flag in order to show the success and failure message. Okay, message simply I have created as null. Global response, whatever the response is coming from the web API, and if I haven't casted it, type casted it, then I am storing over here. And this is a customer form group which I have created in my HTML over here. So I have already shown you this is customer form. So this is a form group. In form group I will be having the controls, and this is input customer. Whatever the input will come, I will hold into this array input customer. After that we have the constructor form builder. Customer service I have injected over here in the constructor. Then in this dot customer form I am building like this. I have kept it all the things as a required validators dot required. Yeah, and validator comes from here, from the Angular forms, as you can see over here. So that's the part of the creating the forms. This is the array which bind up the title drop down list. Then on submit button I am calling this method submit form. I am simply logging this method. I am taking all the value from the customer form and assigning to my this dot input customer. Then whatever the title is there, I am taking particular title value, not the key. Note down, select is having key and value pair. So that's what I am doing over here in the date format. Most of the time you are get confused when you are using the date in the type script. You will get ISO format date. So I am just typecasting that date to EN English. This is how you can do it and you can follow it. Okay, so next I have logged in. Here is my service call. So what I am doing, this dot customer service dot insert customer method I am calling. I'm subscribing that response. Whatever response come, I'm storing in global response result. If error comes, it goes over here, and if it is success, it goes over here. Let me show you inside customer service what is the difference which I was talking about. So first of all, these are the things which has been included in the service: HTTP client, HTTP module, HTTP response, and all those things observable. In Angular 6 onwards, you have to use like this: no more catch and no more throw. Here it's throw error and catch error, as you could notice. And no more map over here. If you wanted to use a map operator, yeah, we should go with the pipe first. So that's what we have done. This is my simply API URL. I have injected HTTP client over here. Then insert customer method, I'm taking this customer model of any type. This is my API URL which will hit 64506. Let us verify the URL. So this my API URL is 64506, which is correct. That's what I wanted to show you. Then in this, return this http.client.post. I'm calling, passing the customer model, then applying the pipe, then mapping the response, and then catch error. In the catch error, simply what I'm doing, whatever the error is coming, just throw that error. So this is the part which is service part, which calls my web API basically. So what is the my web API over here? I will go, this is my web API which is getting called, and here is my post method basically which is getting used, and we are achieving this operation. So I would like to show you the module.ts, how my module.ts looks. These are the modules which has been included in my module.ts. So first of all, you need to import these things, then keep into import sections and use those things. So thanks for watching. If you are having any doubt, if you want the code, you can ask me the code on the comment section and I will provide you the code. And this is how your UI will look like once you have completed everything. So this is about CRUD operation part 1. I will come up with the CRUD operation part 2 for you guys. Thanks for watching.